let us start. Next experiment from 12th standard handbook, sonometer 2. Aim: to study the relation between the length of the given wire and tension for constant frequency using sonometer. So in this experiment we want to find out relation between L and capital T. T and L, this relation we want to find out. And here frequency is kept constant, that means tuning fork is also kept constant. Just like previous article we have seen, this is the instrument, sonometer, wire, bridges, hanger, we require weights. Value of one ring is 0.5 kg, or we can say 500 grams. We require rubber pad, we require a tuning fork, we require a scale. Now, one mark is reserved for your formula. See here, on the handbook it is given, n equal to 1 upon 2L under root T upon M. This is called as the formula. Let us see experiment. Observation. Here, we require mass of the hanger, M0. It is given as 500 grams. Mass of the hanger is 500 grams. So here, see here. Here, hanger has a weight 500 grams. Now we attach one ring to this hanger. So, first column of this is mass added to the hanger 500 grams. So, total mass M0 plus M dash. M0 is 500 and this is 500. Addition, so we get 1000. This is M into 98. M is 1000 into 980. So we get 98 into 10 raised to 4. Value of this. We want to find out vibrating length. So we require again paper rider placed at the center of this wire. We require a suitable tuning fork. This. We require rubber band. Gently hammer and place on the bar. We want to find out that typical length where paper adder falls down. Resonance concept is there. Vibrations of tuning fork and vibrations of this wire when becomes equal at that time. Force frequency and natural frequency perfectly match and this vibrates with maximum amplitude and adder falls down. That length we want to measure. So it is vibrating, not falling. So increase the distance slowly, 1 or 2 millimeter. You want to find out that typical length where paper adder falls down. What is the precaution? Rider should be exactly at the center of this wire. One precaution is there. This rider should be exactly at the center, midpoint, that means midway, between the bridges. It is vibrating, not falling. It is around 10. So 10 cm. I mentioned here 10. 10. 10. One reading is sufficient. L square. 10 square is 100. T upon L square. T is known to us. 98 upon 10 raised to 4 upon 100. So we get 98 into 10 raised to 2. Value of T upon L square. In the same way, now we add one more ring. Second reading. So weight added to this hanger is 1000. So here, because of addition, M0 is 500, we get 1500. And if you multiply this 1500 into 980, we get 147 into 10 raised to 4. Now we want to find out vibrating length. So as tension increases, length also increases. So increase the distance slowly between the bridges and then
less rider vibrations touching to the accelerometer box, not falling, increase distance slowly. Take precaution that rider should be exactly at the center point, midway between the bridges. One more precaution, this should not touch the walls of the table. It should be freely hanging. We want to find out resonance concept. Again, take proper care that this rider should be at the center. Again, increase the distance slowly with proper precaution. Rider should be at the center of this cylinder box, not falling. Again, increase the distance slowly. Not falling. Again, increase the distance slowly. Falls down. Again measure the length. Length with the help of scale. If I measure, we get 11. So 11 is the value of vibrating length.
So mention here 11. Square is 121. In the same way, we add. In the same way, we add one more ring. So we get 1500 mass attached to the hanger. Total weight becomes 2000. And if you multiply by 980, we get 196 into 10 raised to 4. We find out vibrating length just like previous. We get now 12. The square is 144. And if I divide tension by L square, we get around 136 into 10 raised to 2. Same way, add one more ring. So we get 2000 weight added to the hanger. Next column is, if we add mass of hanger, we get 2500. So tension, if you multiply this M by 980, we get 245 into 10 raised to 4 dynes. Again, find out vibrating length. So here we get 13. Square of 13 is 169. And if I divide tension by L square, we get 144 into 10 raised to 2. Now last column, unknown weight. So to find out unknown weight, we take this body as a unknown weight. Remove all rings and attach only this unknown body, unknown weight to this hanger, like this. What is the precaution? This should not touch to the walls of the table. It should be freely hanging. Again, starting position to find out unknown. We don't know what is the mass, what is the weight, and therefore we go to the starting position and find out the point of point of contact between this box and vibrating 24, where paper rider falls down, and I calculated it is around 11.5 at that time. See you on the year in your handbook.
I mentioned here 11.5. I got the length where paper rider falls down. 11.5. Square is 132.25. So here we don't know of mass, tension not known to us. Therefore, last column is T dash. So here we find out mean, this plus this plus this plus this divided by 4, we get 131.0 into 10 raised to 2. We want to find out unknown tension. Sometimes an examination question can be asked. Find out unknown tension by calculation or by graph. So formula is there. Unknown tension is equal to mean T upon L square upon LX square. So we get 131.0 into 10 raised to 2, and we got LX square 132.25. So we got 99.05 weight by calculation. Now suppose question is asked, find out unknown tension by the graph. So graph means tension against L square. So here on one axis we take tension along x axis T, along y axis we take L square. Now scale, see if this column, tension column, it 98 to 245. So choose a scale which contains all readings. So choose a scale 50 into 10 raised to 4, increase by 50, 100 into 10 raised to 4, 150 into 10 raised to 4, 200 into 10 raised to 4, 250 into 10 raised to 4. Scale on x axis, increase by 50 into 10 raised to 4 dyne. Now on y axis, again see this reading, this column of L square, 100 to 169. Take a scale which contains already. So I'll choose a scale 100, 200, 300, 400. Depending upon your choice, you can take any scale what you want. So y axis increase by 100. So 1 cm is equal to 100 centimeter square. Y square, because L square is there. The plot demands when tension is 98, that means almost 100. At that time we got L square as a 100. So 98 into 10 raised to 4, that means 100 into 10 raised to 4, we get this point. In the same way, we plot second point, third point, fourth point, and we get the graph like this. And we want to find out unknown tension. So unknown tension, we know value of Lx square, 132.25. So this graph is a straight line passing through origin. Look at the point 132, almost equal to 130. From this, drop a perpendicular to the y-axis, touching to the graph. From intersecting point, drop perpendicular to the x-axis. This point gives us unknown tension. So we got unknown tension is equal to 170 into 10 raised to 4, 9. So by calculation and by graph, we have find out. So result, this same, 1, 2, 3, 4, not necessary, unknown tension. By graph, we got 170. So this completes your experiment. So in your journal, you have to write down title, aim, apparatus, then formula, diagram, then observation table, then this graph, and show at least one calculation, and finally the result. Result 1, 2, 3, up to this. Fourth is not required. So here completes the experiment.